Easiest way to make a scrunchie. Depends on what width and length you really like. This one's 38 centimetres long by 10 centimetres wide. Cut your thin elastic to be 16 centimetres long or thereabouts. Put a very big safety pin in one end so that you can feel it through your thread so you can pull it through. Okay. Right, so we've got our piece of elastic already cut and a safety pin, large safety pin in one end. On the other side, we've got a big long piece of ribbon, maybe 50, 60 centimetres long, longer than your actual piece of fabric for your scrunchie. And then we're going to just sew this over. Back tack. And when you go over the elastic and ribbon, just back tack it. Get to your corner. Doing roughly centimetre seam allowance, 3/8 of an inch. Make sure that you don't sew on your ribbon, okay? Just keep your ribbon flat. This is the fastest and easiest way to do a scrunchie. Not having to think about it. Before you get to the end, fold it up a centimetre, fold it over a centimetre, then just on a double back tack. So we've folded it under on this side and under on that side, and then when it's bagged out, it's already folded. Okay. Come back to your corner, cut your threads off. Just going to trim that corner so that we can bag it out. Right, you've got your elastic there. So we then pull this piece of ribbon through, which then bags it out. You see me tucking that in? Keep pulling your scrunchie over, folding it back on itself. And you can be really clever and do it. Keep your elastic there. Hold these corners out. You can pop a pair of snips in there. Push out your corners. One side. Be careful you don't cut through your fabric. Other side, so you've got a nice square edge. Still got your elastic here. Right. You can pull that out. Hold on to your elastic. And then, because we've already folded over that top edge, it's a lot easier to then put our scrunchie. Just check that it's not twisted. You've got your flat edge down the bottom. Then what we can do is bring that elastic around and stitch it over the top of our end before we take the safety pin out. It's very hard to do if you've got a really short piece of elastic. So, take this out. Just going to catch it again. Just probably 5 mils or so. And back tack it. So that doesn't let go. Right. Then we can cut off this piece of ribbon because we don't need that anymore. We've already bagged it out. Okay, then we can fold over our centimeter that we've already folded over. Our edges to our edges. Tuck it in. Make sure it's overlapping where we've just stitched, and just stitch straight across the top. Okay. Make sure everything's tucked in. And that you can't see your elastic hanging out anywhere. It's all tucked in. Right. And it's sitting straight over the top of each other. And I'll just.
You can hand sew this section if you'd prefer, and then you don't have any stitching showing to the outside.
Trim off your threads. Make sure that it's caught. There we go. We have a scrunchie done. It can be wider, it can be longer and more gathered, ready to go. Perfect.
The scrunchie on the left-hand side of this photo is the one that we've just made in this video. The one on the right-hand side is actually double the measurement, so you can choose how much scrunch to have in your scrunchie.
Loving the scrunchies. I've got some on my wrists and if you go to the nth degree with these scrunchies, we can do so many different possibilities. Okay, so here we have the world's biggest scrunchie, which doubles as a beautiful mask with a dusty top. Okay, you can press it down flat, or you can just have it nice and poppy, put it over a t-shirt, or wear it on its own. Okay, what else could we do? Let's see. So everyone could have this lovely matching scrunchie to go on the end of their t-shirt, which adds a bit of colour to your outfit. You could have a matching brooch or something. Then, have you ever had a t-shirt that the sleeve is just not long enough? Okay, well, you might be tall and never get long enough sleeves. Well, whack yourself a really big scrunchie, and you can pop it over your arms, so the sleeve is shorter, or you can go up to your elbows, and have this extravagant scrunchie on your sleeve, okay? Then, instead of the short little one, on the other side as well. Now it's short at the front, and fold it up, and tuck it in. And have it long at the side like that. Now it's up to you however you want it. You can have it at your elbows. I'm having a thing done. I've just moved my scrunchie up here, down to around my waist, with a little cap and skirt. Okay. You could put these here, you could pop them right up higher. It's like a really puffball sleeve, if you needed something else. I've got an elastic of like 20 centimetres. Okay. You, like you could tuck up the bottom bit and the top bit. That just looks like a massive big scrunchie. Okay. Nice little jazzy colour for your outfit. Okay. Or just have it attached at the bottom as we'd say. Yeah, okay. You can also wear it, of course, many, many different ways. Let's see. We can also pop these little scrunchy pieces down onto the legs and pull this up shorter, or we can go down longer onto our feet with a pair of heels. Looks fabulous on anyone. We live in the 80s. Okay, this one is a favourite of mine. If your shoes don't match your outfit, you can actually put your covers down long enough so that they cover your shoes.
This is my 9-year-old daughter's interpretation of her scrunchies.
These scrunchies are also perfect if you don't like wearing heels and you have flat shoes, or if you need to, you'll be in this ball. You can put your rhinestones on, cover them, and make them quite pretty. And no one can make it really rhinestone. Perfect. Well, because scrunchie can also be used as a neck collar. So you could tuck it up under at the front and just have it wider. Have your shoulders have nice brooches at them. And then, okay, so many possibilities. One shoulder top, why not? What's the other thing? What do you think? You even put a matching one on your arm. Oh, another layer. Further down, and you can completely asymmetric. Lots of different ideas. You just have to be a little bit creative, a little bit arty. Okay, so our leg warmers, armbands, wristbands can also be worn as our scrunchie. Okay, so it's a bigger scrunchie in someone's hand. Okay, you can tuck it in smaller, you can branch it out a little longer, and have it standing on end as a wristband. Okay, so a few months ago in Vogue magazine, had lots of showing Vogue magazine, had lots of different ways where they could slot them out. So this one can still have your ponytail in. Have it folded up, maybe keep it with a clip. Yeah, something different. Try something else. So the point I'm trying to make today is that whatever you're doing, whatever project you're working on, whether it's hems, whether it's seams, whether it's scrunchies, whether it's garter belts, which is where scrunchies come from. Early, humble cousin of scrunchie is garter belt. So whatever you're doing, whatever you're working on, the point I'm trying to make is just to be a little bit elaborate, be a little bit extravagant. This is the fashion industry, and we like to try new and different things, okay? Extend on your learning, try something different, get a really big scrunchie, and just be extravagant, see what you come up with. It's great, it's a lot of fun, and that's what I'm trying to prompt everyone to do. I'm giving you hints and tips and ideas into progressing and learning and doing something different and enjoying it, you know? Add a bit of colour to your life. Do something different. So enjoy. Thank you. And I'll see you next week. We've got a really interesting topic on masks. How to measure your mask, how to get the mask to fit yourself, how to get enough layers of the mask, and different styles. What suits you? What goes with your outfit? Okay? Thanks very much. See you next week. So enjoy.